I have an extra one, so I can go down to there.
Oh, I thought it was funny.
You know, the seven-string guitar developed in Brazil as an accompanying instrument. They found if they used it with a band, they didn't need a bass player. didn't have to divide the money quite so much when they played their things. Then a lot of Brazilians started writing music for the seven-string guitar. A lot of it can't be played without that seventh string. So I broke down and bought one a couple of years ago. So this next piece is by Armando Neves, who was one of Brazil's best-known composers during the 1940s and 50s. This is a piece titled Ma Foi, which is an unusual Brazilian word, but it basically means very disorganized or a big mess. Thank you. 1930s and 40s. He started playing when he was very young, and by the time he was 12 years old, he was playing with a number of bands in Rio de Janeiro. Everybody just referred to him as the kid, which is, in Portuguese, that is garoto. And that stuck with him as a stage name throughout his life. In the 1930s, he started performing with Carmen Miranda, who was the Brazilian singer who used to sing and dance with a pineapple and banana in her hair. And he toured the world with her. They actually spent a lot of time playing at a club in New York. And what they would usually do there is Carmen Miranda would finish her set, and then Garoto would play solos late into the night. And he became a favorite of Duke Ellington and Art Tatum, who used to go to the club regularly to hear him play because he was playing a totally different style of music, combining the chords from American jazz with the Afro-Brazilian rhythms. So I'd like to play several of his works. The first of these is titled Duas Contas. The seventh string guitar is it uses a lot of different tunings. Seventh string, I've tuned it, depending on what I'm playing, sometimes it's a B, sometimes it's a B flat, sometimes an A, sometimes a C. So Garoto was probably the first composer of bossa nova in Brazil, where Antonio Carlos Jobim was famous for writing bossa novas in about 1959. As early as the early 1940s, Garoto was composing some bossa novas. So this is one of his early ones titled George do Fusa. So this is probably Garoto's best known work, titled Lamentos do Morro, which means Cries of the Hills. Thank you. Costa is probably today's best-known Brazilian guitarist. He started playing when he was very young. He grew up in a musical family. And he showed such promise at the guitar that his father decided to buy a van. And they drove all over South America living in the van. He would just take Yamandu to whatever teacher could teach him anything about music. And so Yamandu learned to play music of the Inca Indians right from the Incas. Learned to play Argentine tangos from tango players, sambas from the sambistas. And put together all these different styles. He studied classical music as well. And has developed a very interesting style of composing. So I'd like to play a couple of his works to finish off. These are actually two homages written to honor other Brazilian guitarists. The first, Menino Baden, is an homage to Baden Powell, who was probably Brazil's best-known guitarist during the 60s and 70s. And the second one, Samba para Rafa, is an homage to Rafael Rabelo, who was one of Brazil's best guitarists during the 1980s and 90s. Thank you.
Thank you.
is a flamenco piece by José Gallardo del Rey, El Fuego, which means fire. Thank you.